In this video, we'll compare performance of Dina V2 versus Bun and Node.js in Kubernetes. As always, we'll focus on four golden signals. In the first test, we'll measure latency from the client side using P99 percentile. The output for each application will be measured in requests per second and will generate enough load to find the breaking point of all three applications. Then we'll measure service saturation, or how full the services are. In this case, we'll measure CPU usage of each application relative to the limits defined in Kubernetes, as well as memory usage. Additionally, since we deploy all applications to Kubernetes and they are all CPU bound, we need to measure CPU throttling. As soon as Kubernetes starts throttling your service, you can expect significant degradation in performance. Finally, we'll measure errors or availability of the service, which for HTTP-based applications means the ratio of successful requests to the total number of requests. The second test will more or less simulate a real-world use case. Each time application receives a POST request with JSON payload, it needs to parse the request body, generate UUID for the object, and save it to the relational database. In our case, latest Postgres 17.0. For this test, I internally instrumented both applications with Prometheus metrics to measure each function call that saves item to the database. Additionally, I use Node Exporter to monitor the database itself, along with a Postgres Prometheus exporter to track the number of active connections established by each application to the database. For all my tests, I use production-ready Kubernetes cluster in AWS. I use large instances with two CPUs to run the applications, four extra-large Graviton instances to run the clients, and i3EN extra-large instance to run Postgres, which comes with 2 TB SSD. For these tests, I create EKS cluster in AWS and provision 2 instance groups. The first is used for the applications, and the second is used to deploy all my clients to generate load. Since these applications mostly use a single thread, there are 2 options for scaling. You can use cluster mode and implement that in each application, or simply limit the CPU shares each instance gets to a single CPU and scale it horizontally. Both approaches deliver similar performance. To deploy clients, I use Kubernetes job and create 20 pods for each application to generate load. I start with 20 truly independent clients and then gradually increase the number of virtual clients, reaching around 4,000 total by the end of the test. For the second test, I provision EC2 instance for Postgres and use pgtune to optimize Postgres for the hardware. Each time the app receives a request, it saves the item to Postgres. We collect CPU and memory metrics using CIAdvisor from the pods and Node Exporter from the Postgres. I also use Prometheus Postgres Exporter to collect connection count metrics, and we visualize everything in Grafana. When it comes to the source code, I basically used the same code base, just copied from the Node.js with some adjustments. For example, in Bun, I used Bun serve, and the Dina project is almost identical copy of the Bun version. The only difference is that I initialized it with Dina CLI and replaced Bun serve with Dina serve. So in terms of portability, it's great. In the Docker file, you can see exact version I used and the command to compile each project. For example, this is command I used for Bun. I didn't find much documentation on running Dina in production, except for the Docker images with a new Dina install command that replaces Dina cache. For the Node.js, I installed all the production dependencies and used Google's distroless image for the final stage. Alright, let's go ahead and run the first test. If you saw my previous benchmark between Node.js and Bun, you would notice similar behavior. Bun has the highest latency. By the way, I have updated Bun to the latest version in this video. Following that is Node.js, and surprisingly, Dina shows even lower latency than Node.js at the start of the test. CPU usage for the Node.js is also the highest, so it's expected to fail first. Then we have Dina, and Bun is the most efficient in terms of CPU utilization. Once again, Bun is based on the new Zig programming language, while Dina is based on Rust and Tokyo runtime. I also have another test comparing Rust and Zig in their pure form if you're interested. On the right hand side, we have memory usage. I set a limit of 256 MB, and you can see the usage on the graph. At around 15,000 requests per second, Node.js starts to lose its latency advantage compared to Bun, which happens at around 35% CPU usage. This is something to keep in mind if you're using Node.js, as you may want to scale it horizontally at this point if you need low latency. You can also see some downward spikes in latency. Typical latency per request is under 1 millisecond for this test, and I set the client timeout to 100 milliseconds. When a request reaches 100 milliseconds and times out, you'll see that spike in the availability graph. At around 30,000 requests per second, Node.js can no longer keep up with other applications, and its latency spikes. I'll remove Node.js latency from the graph for the remainder of the test and show the full graph at the end. You can see that Kubernetes starts throttling Node.js, and at this point, scaling should be considered. By around 36,000 requests per second, Dina's latency begins to match Bun's latency and eventually surpasses it. In this graph, lower latency is better, and you can see Bun remains quite stable at this level, while also using significantly less CPU. By around 60,000 requests per second, Dina begins dropping some requests, and its latency spikes as well. Kubernetes also starts throttling. Now, let's find the breaking point for the Bun application. At around 88,000 requests per second, Bun starts to fail. Dina managed to reach around 80,000 requests per second, while Node.js only reached 50,000 requests per second. Alright, let me go ahead and open each graph for the entire test duration. The test ran for around 2 hours. First, we have requests per second. At around 33,000 requests per second, Node.js started to degrade. Dina started to degrade at around 60,000 requests per second, and Bun at around 80,000 requests per second. Next, we have latency measured from the client side. You can see that Node.js has the highest latency, followed by the Dina, and Bun has the lowest. Now, let's take a look at the beginning of the test. It looks like Dina can produce much lower latency when it's not overloaded. Then we have CPU usage. Bun is the most efficient application, followed by the Dina, and lastly Node.js. Next is memory usage. Bun appears very stable, while Node.js and Dina use significantly more memory. Then we have availability graph. As expected, by the end of the test, Node.js has the lowest availability. Let's also take a look at Bun and Dina's performance. Finally, we have CPU throttling. Kubernetes starts throttling Node.js first, followed by Dina, and lastly Bun. So if you're building a client-facing application where latency is very important, you might consider using Dina. On the other hand, if latency is not as critical and the application needs to handle a large workload, such as internal application doing some kind of transformation, Bun has higher throughput. Alright, let's go ahead and run the second test with Postgres. In this test, I measure latency using P90 percentile to reduce the noise in the graph. I think I found a bug in Bun. This is the second time I have seen this behavior. There are CPU and latency spikes. Initially, I thought the bug in BAN was related to the database, but based on this graph, it seems more likely that the issue lies in how BAN parses the JSON payload or generates UUID. This is not normal behavior at such low load with only 20% CPU usage. Now, regarding overall performance, unfortunately, Dina is the slowest application in this test with CPU usage much higher than both Node.js and BAN. It appears that most of the latency in Dina is caused by the database requests, which is also why the client latency for the entire request is slower. Additionally, Dina's CPU usage was higher in this test compared to the other applications. It seems like all three applications handle roughly the same number of requests, possibly because the database is the bottleneck. For the next tests, I'll use larger EC2 instances to run the database. Now, let's take a look at the entire test. First, we have requests per second graph. Next is client latency. From this graph, you can see that something is definitely off with BAN, and I hope they can fix it. Overall, Node.js has the lowest latency, while Dina has the highest. Next, we have database latency. You can see that most of the Dina's latency comes from database requests, whereas BAN and Node.js have much lower database latency, almost 5 times lower than Dina. Let me know what you think could be causing such a drastic difference. Next is the CPU usage graph. Then we have memory usage graph. I also tracked the connection pool size. I set the maximum connection size to 40 per instance and deployed 2 instances, resulting in 80 connections per application. So it's not like Dina is using a single connection while the other applications are using a connection pool. Here is the CPU throttling graph. That's pretty much it for this test. I have a playlist with other benchmarks you may find interesting. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.